Jai Hind children, welcome in your history class. Today the topic which I am going to start is visualizing the nation children. In the 18th and 19th centuries, artists, they represented nation as a human form. Means they wanted to give a human face to the nation children. So the artists, they wanted to show a female figure as the allegory of the nation. Okay, but the female figure was not actually a real life woman. मतलब कोई real life में कोई ऐसी औरत नहीं थी, एक face दिया गया. Normally we used to call India also as a motherland, isn't it? भारत माता कहते हैं ना हम लोग. तो in the same way, in the 18th and 19th centuries, artists they wanted to represent nation as a human form. And normally female figures, they were representing the nation and they were known as allegory of the nation children. So we are going to start this topic children, visualizing the nation. You can see the chart topic on the screen children, visualizing the nation children. So artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they were personifying a nation in a human form children, and this is known as allegory. Okay, so artists in the 18th and 19th century, they found a way out by personifying a nation. Matlab nation ko ek person maan karke baat karna. In other ways, words you can say that they represented a country as if it were a person. Yes children, so while it is easy enough to represent a ruler through a portrait or a statue, but how does one go about giving a face to a nation? So artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation. Matlab nation ko ek person maan karke baat karna. So in other words, they represented a country as if it were a person. So normally artists jo hain, they portrayed nation as a female figure. Okay, so artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation, and they represented a country as if it were a person. So nations were then portrayed as female figures, and the female form that was chosen to personify the nation did not stand for any particular woman in real life. Rather, it sought to give the abstract idea of the nation a concrete form, and that is the female figure became an allegory of the nation children. We used to call Bharat Mata, isn't it children? So Bharat Mata, you can see kahin kahin pe artist ne Bharat Mata ko ek sanyasini ke roop mein bhi dikhaya hai, kahin ke Durga ke roop mein dikhaya hai. It all depends upon the artist children. So artists in the 18th and 19th century, they wanted to give a human form to the nation children, a face to the nation. So artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation. Nation ko ek person ke roop mein dikhana. So in other words, they represented a country as if it were a person, and nations were then portrayed as female figures. Jyadatar tum dekho India mein bhi kaha jata Bharat Mata. So nations at that time were portrayed as female figures children, and the female form that was chosen to personify the nation did not stand for any particular woman in real life. So just female figure ko dikhate the nation ke roop, matlab nation ko ek female figure ke roop mein jab dikhate the, wo jo face dete the ek female ka, wo real life mein koi aurat nahi hoti thi, uska kisi se real life se matlab nahi hota tha. So artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation. They represented a country as if it were a person. And isi ko kaha jata, when we are representing a country, ki jaise wo koi person hai, that is known as allegory. So artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation. In other words, they represented a country as if it were a person. So nations were then portrayed as female figures, and the female form that was chosen टू पर्सनिफाई द नेशन डिड नॉट स्टैंड फॉर एनी पर्टिकुलर वुमेन इन रियल लाइफ. Rather, it sought to give the abstract idea of the nation a concrete form, and that is the female figure became an allegory of the nation. Children, as you have studied in class 9th also, children, that the French Revolution, during the French Revolution, artists used the female allegory to portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and the Republic. Children, these ideas were represented through specific objects or symbols. Yaad hai aapko? Broken chain, then ring. So these were the symbols which were used by the artist. Okay. So during the French Revolution, artists used the female allegory to portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and the Republic. So these ideas were represented through symbols, through specific objects, and the attributes of liberty are the red cap or the broken chain, while justice is generally a blindfolded woman carrying a pair of weighing scales. So artists use female allegory to portray the ideas such as liberty, justice, and the Republic during the French Revolution. Children, so during the French Revolution, artists used the female allegory to portray ideas such as, do you remember that? Liberty, justice, and the Republic. So these ideas were represented through specific objects or symbols. And the attributes of liberty are the red cap, do you remember that? Or the broken chain, while justice is generally a blindfolded woman carrying a pair of weighing scales. So similarly, female allegories were invented by the artist in the 19th century to represent the nation. So the female allegories were invented by artists in the 19th century to represent the nation. So in France, she was Christian Marianne, a popular Christian name which underlined the idea of a people's nation. अगर पूछा जाएगा कि यू हैव टू नेम द एलुगरी ऑफ फ्रांस, दैट इज मारियन. ओके, सो इन फ्रांस शी वाज क्रिश्चियन मारियन, अ पॉपुलर क्रिश्चियन नेम विच अंडरलाइन द आइडिया ऑफ अ पीपल्स नेशन. हर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स मीन्स हर फीचर्स वर ड्रॉन फ्रॉम दोज ऑफ लिबर्टी एंड द रिपब्लिक. द रेड कैप, द ट्राई कलर एंड कोकेट स्टैचूज ऑफ मारियन वर इरेक्टेड इन पब्लिक स्क्वायर्स. ये स्टैचू जो है उसको खड़ा किया गया था पब्लिक प्लेसेस पे, पब्लिक स्क्वायर्स पे, टू रिमाइंड द पब्लिक ऑफ द नेशनल सिंबल ऑफ यूनिटी. ये देख लीजिए, मरियन, शी इज द एलुग्री ऑफ फ्रांस, एंड द स्टैचूज ऑफ मरियन वर इरेक्टेड विद इन द पब्लिक स्क्वायर्स टू रिमाइंड द पब्लिक ऑफ द नेशनल सिंबल ऑफ यूनिटी, एंड शी वॉज अ सिंबल ऑफ यूनिटी चिल्ड्रेन. And to pursue them to identify with it, Marian images were marked on coins and stamps also. You can see, yes children, you can see the figure 16, postage stamps of 1850 with the figure of Marian representing the Republic of France. Yes children, you can see on the screen children. So female allegories were invented by the artist in the 19th century to represent the nation. In France, she was Christian Marian, a popular Christian name, and which underlined the idea of a people's nation. So Marian was the female allegory of France. Do you remember that, children? One mark question can come like this. You have to mention the female allegory. You have to mention the allegory of France. So Marian is the allegory of France, children. So female allegories were invented by artists in the 19th century to represent the nation. In France, she was Christian Marian, a popular Christian name, and which underlined the idea of people's nation, and her features were drawn from those of liberty and the Republic. The red cap, the tricolor, the cockade, and the statues of Marian were erected where? In public squares. Why? To remind the public of the national symbol of unity. Means Marian was a symbol of national unity, children. So allegory of France was Marian, and she was the symbol of unity. and to persuade them to identify with it, Marian images were marked on coins and stamps, which you can see on the screen, children. Yes, postage stamps of 1850 with the figure of Marian representing the Republic of France. Now, so Marian was the allegory of France. In the same way, Germania became the allegory of the German nation. See, the question can come. Name the allegory of France and Germany. So Marian was the allegory of France, and Germania became the allegory of the German nation. So Germania was the allegory of the German nation. And in visual representations, Germania wears a crown of oak leaves, as the German oak stands for heroism. Yes, you can see the figure. Yes, children, Germania became the allegory of the German nation, and Germania wears a crown of oak leaves, and the German oak leaf stands for heroism, children. You can see Germania, Philip Witt, you know, ne banaya 1848 when the artist prepared this painting of Germania on a cotton banner, as it was meant to hang from the ceiling of the Church of St. Paul, but the Frankfurt Parliament was convened in March 1848. Okay, children, you can see the figure again. So the Germania, allegory of the German nation, and Germania wears a crown of oak leaves, and German oak stands for what? Heroism. Do you remember that? And this, the painter, the artist who prepared this, his name was Philip Witt, and he has created this painting in 1848. The artist prepared this painting of Germania on a cotton banner, as it was meant to hang from the ceiling of the Church of St. Paul, where the Frankfurt Parliament was convened in March 1848. Clear, children? Now you can see the new words, allegory. What does the word allegory means? When an abstract idea, for instance, greed, envy, freedom, liberty, is expressed through a person or a thing, an allegorical story has two meanings, one literal and one symbolic. Again, we are taking this topic, visualizing the nation, children. So in the 18th and 19th centuries, the artists, they want to give a human face to a nation, to the nation, children. So artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation, children. So artists represented, or you can say the artists represent a country in the form of a person, and the nations were portrayed as female figures, and the female figure did not stand for any particular woman in real life, children, and the female figures became the allegory of the nation, children. So the question can come like this, children. How did the artist personify a nation in the 18th and 19th centuries Europe? So artist represents a country in the form of a person, and the nations were portrayed as female figures, and the female figure did not stand for any particular woman in real life, and the female figures became the allegory of the nation, children. So in this topic, that is visualizing the nation, means what do you, the question can come, what does allegory means? Artist prepared, or you can say that artist represented a country as if it were a person, which became the allegory of the nation, children. So it is easy enough to represent a ruler through a portrait or a statue, but it is quite difficult to give a face to a nation. But artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way how to represent a nation. So they wanted to give a human form, a face to the nation, and that normally they used to give a female face to the nation, and the female face became the allegory of the nation, children. So artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation. Nation ko person ke roop mein dikhaya jaye, and in other words, we can say that they represent, the artists, they represented a country as if it were a person. So nations were portrayed as female figures, and the female form that was chosen to personify the nation did not stand for any particular woman in real life. मतलब real life में कोई ऐसी औरत होती नहीं थी जो face दिया जाता था nation को. वो real life से उससे कोई मतलब नहीं था. It just sought to give the abstract idea of the nation to a concrete form, children. And the female figure became an allegory of the nation. So artists represented a country as if it were a person, and which became the allegory of the nation, children. So artists, again I'm telling you, artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they found a way out by personifying a nation. They represent the nation in a human form, children, and they represented a country as if it were a person. And mostly nations were portrayed by the artists as female figures, and the female form that was chosen to personify the nation did not stand for any particular woman in real life, and the female figure became an allegory of the nation, children. Clear? So during the French Revolution, artists used the female allegory to portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and the republic. So during the French Revolution, again female allegory were used by the artists to portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and the republic. Do you remember that? Again, artists were using female allegory to portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and the republic during the French Revolution. So these ideas were represented through specific objects or symbols. ज़्यादातर liberty, justice, and republic को show करने के लिए उन्होंने कुछ objects or symbols को use किया था. So during the French Revolution, artists used the female allegory to portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and republic. And these ideals were represented through objects or symbols, children. And do you remember that the attributes of liberty are the red cap or the broken chain, while justice is generally a blindfolded woman carrying a pair of weighing scales? Similar measurement, female allegories were invented by the artists in the 19th century to represent the nation. So artists, they wanted to give a human form, a human face to the nation, and normally they use female face to personify a nation, children. So female allegories were invented by the artists in the 19th century to represent the nation. In France, Marianne, a popular Christian name, Marianne became the allegory of the French nation, children. So France ke allegory kya bani? Marianne. And in France, she was Christian Marianne, a popular Christian name which underlined the idea of a people's nation. So Marianne became the allegory of France, and Germania became the allegory of Germany, children. So female allegories were invented by the artists in the 19th century to represent the nation. In France, Marianne, which was a popular Christian name, and which underlined the idea of a people's nation, and the main important features were drawn from those of liberty and the republic, wearing red cap, the tricolor, the cockade, and statues of Marianne were erected in public squares. Statues jo the Marianne ke, unko public squares mein janmuch ke khada kiya gaya tha, just to remind the public that she is the symbol of unity. So Marianne became the allegory of France, and which was a popular Christian name, and Marianne, the statues of Marianne were erected in public squares to remind the public of the national symbol of unity and to pursue them to identify with it. कि अपने आप को उसे जोड़ के देखेंगे. She is the allegory of France, children, and she is a symbol of unity. And you can see that Marianne images were marked on coins and stamps. Yes. Postage stamps of 1850 with the figure of Marianne representing the Republic of France, children. Then Germania, in the same way, Marianne, she was the allegory of France, and Germania became the allegory of the German nation. And Germania wears, you can see that in the picture, wears a crown of oak leaves, and as a German oak stands for heroism. Clear, children? You can see the figure. She's wearing the crown. She's wearing a crown of oak leaves, and oak leaf stands for heroism. Germania and Philip Waite in 1848, the artist who prepared this painting of Germania on a cotton banner. Now, you have to learn this also, children. What are the different meanings of the symbols in Germany, children? So, broken chains, the significance being freed. Then, breastplate with eagle, symbol of the German Empire, that is strength. Crown of oak leaves, heroism. Sword, readiness to fight. Olive branch around the sword, willingness to make peace. Then black, red and gold tricolor, flag of the liberal nationalist in 1848, banned by the dukes of the German states. Rays of the rising sun, beginning of a new era. So these were the different symbols which were used by Germany. You can see on the screen, children, and you have to learn it also. What was the significance of broken chains? So these are the different symbols, meanings of the symbols which were used by Germany, children. Broken chains, being freed. Then breastplate with eagle, symbol of the German Empire, that strength. Crown of oak leaves, heroism. Sword, readiness to fight. Then olive branch around the sword, willingness to make peace. Then black, red and gold tricolor, flag of the liberal nationalists in 1848, banned by the dukes of the German states. And the last one, rays of the rising sun, that is beginning of a new era. So these are the different symbols and the meanings and its importance are mentioned on the screen, children. Yes, children, one more picture you can see on the screen, the Fallen Germania, painted by Julius in 1850. Then again, one more figure, and that is, again, Germania guiding the Rhine, River Rhine. You can see on the screen, children. Again, she's wearing a crown of oak leaves. You can see on this picture, children. Yes. Yes, in figure 19, Germania, the allegory of Germany, children, guarding the River Rhine. In 1860, the artist Lorenz Classen was commissioned to paint this image. The inscription of Germania sword reads, "The German sword protects the German Rhine," children. So, what we are studying today, children, that what do you mean by allegory, or why artists were using a human face to personify a nation, children. They wanted to give a human face to the nation, isn't it? And the different, you have studied that the allegory of France and Germany, allegory of France is, yes, children, the allegory of France is Marianne and the allegory of Germany is Germania, children. So do remember that Germania, she's wearing a crown of oak leaves and the German oak stands for heroism, children. Clear? And the statue of Marianne in France, children, the statue of Marianne were erected in public squares to remind the public of the national symbol of unity, children. And even Marianne images were marked on coins and stamps. Clear, children? So just really easy. This topic, that is visualizing the nation, that artists were using a human face to personify a nation. And normally artists uses female face, female figures to personify a nation. And actually this female face or female form did not stand for any particular woman in real life. So the female figure became an allegory of the nation, children. So what you have studied, that artists in the 18th and 19th centuries, they were personifying a nation by giving a human face to the nation, children. So they represented a country as if it were a person, and normally nations were portrayed as female figures, children. And the female form that was chosen to personify the nation did not stand for any particular woman in real life, and the female figure became an allegory of the nation. Then we have studied that during the French Revolution, artists used the female élogrée to portray ideas such as liberty, justice, and the republic. Then female élogrées were invented by the artists in the 19th century to represent the nation. In France, Marion, she was chosen as a élogrée of France, and Germania became the élogrée of the German nation. And in Germania, she wears a crown of oak leaves, and the German oak stands for heroism, children. Then we have studied that the meaning of the symbols and its importance in Germany. Children, broken chains, it means the importance is being freed. Then breastplate with eagle, symbol of the German Empire strength. Then crown of oak leaves, heroism. Sword, readiness to fight. Then olive branches around the sword, willingness to make peace. Then black, red, and gold tricolor. Flag of the liberal nationalist in 1848, which was banned by the dukes of the German states, and rays of the rising sun, that is the beginning of a new era. And I'm going to give some questions also, children, in your WhatsApp group, and you have to write the answers in your fear notebook, children. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.